for Valkyrie Aviation Private Limited. It's an honor to welcome our chief guest, Vibhuti Dhananjaya, to enhance a beautiful topic regarding leadership skills, leader versus manager. We welcome you, ma'am. The session is over to you.
Thank you so much. It is indeed a pleasure to be part of this web talk series. And yes, as you've mentioned that it is a beautiful topic about leaders and managers. And I think that's the need of 21st century, that we all have to realize that, are we good leaders or are we good managers? So I guess let's start. So I'll be sharing my screen and there's a kind of a presentation. I'll keep taking forward from there. So are we managers or leaders? It's a very important question that I think each one of us, we all have to ask ourselves. And there's a very thin line in between being a good leader or a manager. So if you see, can you all see that image? Well, if you can see my screen. So there are two images, one for leaders and one for managers. And there's a very thin line and there's a difference between both the images. If you can see the top one, the leader is leading group of five people. You know, he's leading a team. He's making and creating a path for his followers. And simultaneously, if you see that a manager, he's only ordering a team to work. He's not leading a team. He's only giving orders that, okay, go do this, go do that. So there is a very thin line. When you become a good leader, it is very important for you to actually lead team, to actually mold your team, create a path for them. And when you want to become a manager, you just instruct. I think that's a very simple task to do. So what are the traits of a good leader? You know, a good leader, he coaches the employees. And when I say coaches the employees, that means he molds the employee and get the desired results out of him. He trained them in a particular manner. He stand with them in a particular manner so that they can perform well. They can achieve their targets. Leaders, they work on goodwill. It is not necessary for a leader to actually, you know, be appointed by a company or something. You can yourself choose to become a leader and lead a group of people. So you work on a goodwill. For example, if I have a goodwill with 10 odd people, I can lead that team. It's not necessary that that position has to be given to me. It is just that I work on the goodwill. Leaders, they create enthusiasm and motivation. It is very important these days if we talk about a lot of things about mental health, wellness and other things and people not being very motivated and enthusiastic to work. It is very important for a leader to create that enthusiasm, to create that motivational factor for its team. Leaders, they say we and not I. You know, most of us, there are times that when we are in a part of a team, the managers, they are always like, I am the managers. But leaders, they are very different. They say we. We means we as whole, holistically as a team. They fixes the breakdown. If there is a problem that occurs in the team, if there's a problem that occurs that, you know, a particular kind of work is not able to get completed, then leader, he fixes with the solution. He doesn't just, you know, randomly abscond or vanish from the situation, but he fixes the situation and the problems for his team. Also, the very major quality of a leader is that he shows things how are they done. You know, they give an example, they do it, what we call the experiential learning. That's a major trait of a leader, that they actually show how things are done. They develop people. You know, it is very important for a leader to actually mold, make his team flexible and develop their skill sets. Most of the time, if you work for a company or you work for any kind of a team, there are times that the people who are managing the teams, they don't work on people, they don't work on the team members, they only work on achieving a set targets, they only work on achieving set goals. But a good leader who works actually on a goodwill and work holistically with the team, try to develop people. When I say develop people, is developing their skill sets, is developing, you know, their skills. So it is very important for a leader to develop those people. Also to give credit for the good work done by the team. Once the team is set with the skill set, have a good leader, leader who creates motivation, who creates enthusiasm in the people and give credits, right? And then holistically, that team generates good results. So these are the basic 8 traits of a good leader. Coming to traits of a manager. See, if you can see there, the points are almost similar, but there's a very thin line in between. First one is, for a trait of a manager, it was that they coach the employees. But if you talk about a manager, they drives employees. You know, they don't do the work. They don't show them how the things are done. They just drive them. They move ahead and the team follows. Simple, very clear. Depends on the authority. It is very important that the managers, they are appointed. They don't work on goodwill. If you're a team of 15 odd people, you will just not, you know, let anybody manage the team until and unless the company that you work for, they hire them on that particular position. They inspire fear. They don't create motivation. You know, hum sabko manager se dar lagta hai. Boss ka call aa raha hai. Oh, kyun aa raha hai? Boss ka abhi kyun call aa raha hai? Wo kya baat karna chahta hai? Because they instill that fear in us. It is, they don't create that enthusiasm. I don't think any one of us, we pick our boss's call with a lot of enthusiasm. With most of the time we pick their calls, you know, out of fear, out of anxiety that why are they calling you? Most of the time the managers, they are like, my team, I am leading the team. I am the manager of the team. And they don't say, I have a good team. We are whole. We are complete. We are one team. But they're like, I am doing this. I am doing that. They place blame on team for breakdown. If we go back to the previous slide, a leader, he fixes the breakdown. But if you talk about a manager, he blames on the team for breakdown. If, for example, we are unable to, you know, meet our targets for a particular month, or we are unable to do a particular task, then a manager will be very clear-cut in his answer of saying that my XYZ team member has not done that. It is never about the manager who can say that it is my team, I take the full onus. But they are like, XYZ person has not completed it. Knows how it is done. If we go back again, they show how things are done. You know, they give examples about it. They give experiential learning about it. But managers, they are very clear that the team knows how it is done. They don't give any firsthand experiences to them. They take credits. They use people. Okay, you do this. You are aligned, you know, given this accountability, you are giving this authority, you are responsible for this. And at the end of the day, when everything goes fine and when everything is said, then managers, they are very clear that it is my team. I am managing them. I have done this. I have done that. And lastly, they command. They just give orders. So there's a very thin line that you want to become a good leader or you want to become a good manager. Because if you want to order people, you want to command and only take credit of what your group is doing, what your team is doing, then you're a manager and not a leader. So now we'll do a small comparison of leaders and managers and their roles. So first is leaders, they may or may not have officially appointed to the position. It is not necessary, as I've mentioned, that leaders have to be appointed. It's a mutual decision of a team or a group of people to mutually decide on a one person so that the one person can lead a team as a leader. It's not necessary that they are officially appointed on that particular position. But managers, on the other hand, they are officially appointed. They're officially appointed by the company. They are working on behalf of the company. They work as a boss. They just command you. They sit on your head and get the work done. Then again, leaders. See, now the point is that they may or may not be successful as managers. It is not necessary that leaders are successful as managers. We have just done the traits of leaders and managers. So now you all can understand that it is not necessary that a good leader can be a good manager. It is not necessary that a leader who is appointed to lead a team can actually manage a team. But our managers are managers as long as they hold that particular position. So managers will remain managers and leaders may not be managers. Next point. Leader is the person who leads command or a group of people, who leads a group of people, who give, you know, certain kind of instruction and help them achieve those instruction being a part of that group. Whereas managers are the people for administering or controlling a group of people. They are responsible. They control those 20, 25 odd people as managers. They don't lead a team. As you've seen the first image, they only control people by telling them do this, do that, work and work not. Leader is a person who rules, guides and inspires others. You know, very important is in this particular comparison is that a leader is the person who inspires others. You know, it is very difficult for us as individuals to actually inspire somebody to do something. But if you want to become a good leader, then you have to inspire people. You have to motivate people. You have to create an aura so that those people, they understand what you're saying and can be molded. They can develop their skill sets and work. So a leader, the major quality of a leader is that he inspires others. Whereas the managers, they only control the professional activities. They are not bothered about how you are as an individual. What is your being? When I say being, that how are you feeling when you're working? Are you frustrated when you're working? Are you irritated when you're working? Are you not happy in your personal space? Are you not happy in your professional space? Or any other thing that is bothering you? A manager is never concerned about it. A manager is only concerned about it. Are you meeting your targets? Are you okay moving towards your set goals? Are you completing your responsibilities? Are you reporting on time? Are you doing this? Are you doing that? Right? So a manager is a person who's only concerned about those professional activities. Whereas a leader, he inspires. He will come talk to you. He will come try to sort your problems. He will come, probably if you're having any kind of issues in your personal or professional life, he will help you resolve those issues so that you can perform better. So that he creates a kind of happy atmosphere around you for your working. So a leader and a manager, they work this way. Leaders have power and authority to enforce decision as long as followers are willing to lead. For example, I am leading a group, you know, your team. And today I take a decision, but you don't like it. You're not willing to follow it. So as a leader, it is my responsibility to take back that decision and come out with something which can be, which my followers are willing to accept. Whereas the managers, they have this authority. You know, they have this authority to enforce any kind of a decision till the time they are working on that profile. If your boss says something that this particular task has to be done or this particular thing has to be done, right? So you accept it. I think there are very few of us who will anyway get up and question that, why are we doing this? We don't want to do this. You should change this, right? But if you're led by a person who's very humble, who's very people's person, who's very enterprising and leading you and not managing you, you will still have the ability to go and question. Right? So that's one major comparison between a leader and a manager. Then leader influence others towards goal setting, either formally or informally. When I say formally and informally, it's a very thin line. There are times that, you know, people, they share a kind of a personal bond, the personal relationship with their seniors, their leaders. You know, so if you're not very keen to understand, you know, why are we setting this goal in a very formal manner? You may not like it when it is just thrown on you as a responsibility. A leader, they take chance to talk to you informally, probably going out with you, having a discussion with you, having a cup of coffee and discussing things about it. So that's an informal culture a leader can work upon. But managers, they just work on a set pattern, their set policies, rules and regulations. If a manager is a very hardcore manager, you will never find them going, sitting with the colleagues, having lunch together, having a coffee together, and then discussing work. They will be very clear. They will just circulate their decisions and will want the team to actually accept it. Leaders are interested in risk-taking and exploring new ideas. There are times when a single person is unable to actually take a decision. Right? Then leaders with the whole talking between the whole team, they are ready to move on to take risk, explore new ideas. When 10 people sit together and explore things, there are variety of new ideas that are generated. But managers, they are orderly, controlled, and rational equitable structure. They have a set structures that they work on. They don't want new ideas. They have a company policy and they will keep working on that policies. Then leaders relate to people personally in an intuitive or empathetic manner. Leaders are more humble. Leaders are more emotional. Leaders are more kind. They value people more than managers, where managers only relate to people according to their role. If there's a manager, he will relate to a subordinate probably as a junior manager, not as an XYZ person who's sweet, simple, nice, casual, or whatever. But a manager, he will only relate to somebody as their junior colleagues. Leaders, they feel rewarded by personal achievement. If they are leading a group of team, they are happy with the result. That feels very motivated for a leader himself also. Wherein a manager, he's only happy when the set targets and goals are met, when the team is okay about doing the particular targets at one time or completion of a set goal at particular time, then a manager is happy. But a leader is happy if I am a leader and my team is working and XYZ person has achieved something, I feel happy about it as a leader because I am molding that person. If my colleague is not doing anything, I feel sad about it because that's my team. But a manager is only concerned about people working towards the organizational targets and goals. Now, another very important thing is that what kind of a skill set one should have to become a good leader? And we call them leadership skills. So leadership skills are those skills which a leader must possess to enable his or her influence and inspire the followers to attain desired objectives and goals. The skill set that you require to become a good leader so that you can actually inspire people, you can actually motivate people to perform particular tasks. How are they acquired? You know, they're acquired. If I am leading a group of team, I would want to know what other leaders are doing. I want to observe them. I want to imitate them so that I can become that successful leader. So the most effective leadership skills that one should have to become a good leader are personal skills, communication skills, thinking skills, delegating skills, and decision-making skills. Coming to personal skills, what are personal skills? A leader must have the ability to motivate and influence himself first. He has to impress himself before he impresses others. I think that's a very commendable thought one must have, that, you know, it is important for us to be contented in our own self. It is very important for us to actually motivate our own self, inspire our own self before we move on to inspiring other people. We should always have this trait to gauge what is missing in us, what we should do about it. How do we upgrade ourselves before we step out and start doing it for people? So a very important skill a leader should have is the personal skill that, you know, I can judge. I can manage myself. I can have a direction for myself. I can have a discipline for myself before I step out of my comfort zone and start doing it for people and become a leader. Next is the thinking skills. You know, it is very important that a leader should possess some kind of a strategy in his head, right? I should be able, as a leader, I should be able to think what is next. I should be able to actually determine that what I'm going to do if XYZ things go wrong.